Welcome to these audio slides on the impact of managerial overconfidence on corporate finance decisions. My name is Manfred Frühwirth. I am professor of finance at WU Wien, which is Vienna University of Economics and Business. The purpose of these audio slides is to give you a short overview how managerial overconfidence affects the financial decisions of companies. For that purpose, let us browse some slides from my behavioral corporate finance course. First of all, slide 30 shows the impact of managerial overconfidence on the perceived future cash flows from the investment projects. Overconfident managers overestimate the quality and the success of their investment projects. As a result, they overestimate the expected future cash flows from their investment projects. Based on this, slide 31 describes the impact of managerial overconfidence on the cost of capital charged to the company by the capital market in the perception of the managers. As the managers overestimate their investment projects, they also overestimate the dividends that they can pay out to their shareholders in the future. Comparing the expected future dividends with the current stock price, one can calculate the expected return of the stock. This represents the cost of equity charged to the company by the capital market. As the managers overestimate the future dividends, the cost of equity charged by the capital market in the perception of the managers is too high. As the managers overestimate their investment projects, they also underestimate the probability that the firm will go bankrupt in the future. This makes them overestimate the future expected coupons and repayments of their bonds outstanding. Comparing the expected future payments to the bondholders with the current bond price, one can calculate the expected yield to maturity of the bond. This represents the cost of debt charged to the company by the capital market. As the managers overestimate the expected future payments to the bondholders, the cost of debt charged by the capital market in the perception of the managers is too high. The upward arrows on the right-hand side symbolize that the overestimation of the cost of capital charged by the capital market is stronger for equity than for debt. This comes from the fact that the claims of the equity holders are more sensitive to the well-being of the company than the claims of the debt holders. For debt holders, the only thing that matters is that the company survives the coupon dates and the repayment date. Therefore, in the perception of the managers, the cost of equity charged by the capital market is exaggerated more than the cost of debt. Based on this, slide 32 shows the impact of managerial overconfidence on the capital structure decision. The overestimation of the perceived cost of capital charged to the company by the capital market for external financing leads to a pecking order of the capital structure. The company uses first internal financing because the retained earnings are not subject to the perceived overcharging by the capital market. Second, external debt. As the managers perceive an overcharging by the capital market, but the perceived overcharging is smaller for debt than for equity. And third, external equity. As a last tool, due to the perceived strong overcharging for equity. Based on the coverage so far, slides 34 to 36 analyze the impact of managerial overconfidence on the investment policy, which means on the capital budgeting decisions. Altogether, there are three effects. First, as already described on slide 30, overconfident managers overestimate the expected future cash flows from their investment projects. Second, overconfident managers underestimate the risk of their investment projects. As a result, they underestimate the fundamental WACC, which is the risk-adjusted WACC. The third effect is, as already described on slide 31, overconfident managers perceive the cost of capital charged by the capital market for external financing as too high. The first two effects on slide 34 make the managers perceive the investment project as too attractive. The third effect, on slide 35, goes into the opposite direction. The synthesis of these partly counteracting effects is shown on slide 36. If there are sufficient internal funds available in the company, there is no external financing required. Therefore, the managers will apply in their capital budgeting process the fundamental WACC. As they underestimate the fundamental WACC, the perceived NPV goes up. This may lead to an overinvestment problem. Overinvestment problem means that the managers implement an investment project with an actually negative NPV as they perceive a positive NPV, because of the too high cash flows. So with their investment decision, they destroy shareholder value, but think they create shareholder value. If, however, the company also needs external funds, the managers will apply in their capital budgeting process the WACC charged by the capital market. As they overestimate the WACC charged by the capital market, the perceived NPV goes down. Therefore, the overestimation of the NPV, resulting from the overestimated expected cash flows, can be mitigated by the overestimation of the WACC. Putting these two effects together, if the cash flow effect is stronger than the WACC effect, the perceived NPV goes up. This may create an overinvestment problem, as described before. If, however, the WACC effect is stronger than the cash flow effect, the perceived NPV goes down. So the overinvestment problem caused by the overestimation of the cash flows can be healed by the WACC effect. However, in that case, even an underinvestment problem may occur. This is the case if the managers reject an investment project with an actually positive NPV as they perceive a negative NPV because of the too high WACC. Slide 39 shows the resulting impact of managerial overconfidence on the dividend policy. Altogether, there are two underlying effects of managerial overconfidence on the dividend policy. First, as already described on slide 34, overconfident managers overestimate the expected future cash flows from their investment projects, and they underestimate the fundamental WACC. Therefore, they have a tendency towards overinvestment. This increases the financing needs. Second, as shown on slide 31, The managers perceive the cost of external financing by issuing stocks or bonds as too high. Therefore, they try to avoid external financing. As a result, they need more internal funds. Putting both effects together, to make sure to have enough internal funds to finance their projects, they have to reduce the dividends. Finally, slide 40 shows the impact of managerial overconfidence on stock repurchases. As mentioned before several times, overconfident managers overestimate the expected future cash flows from their investment projects. Therefore, they overestimate the expected dividends that their shareholders will receive in the future. Moreover, the overconfident managers underestimate the risk of their investment projects, and this translates into an underestimation of the risk of their stock. As a result, they underestimate the risk-adjusted cost of equity used for the valuation of their stock. Therefore, the overconfident managers overvalue the stocks issued by them. Comparing their internal valuation with the stock price at stock exchange, they come to the conclusion that their stock is underpriced by the stock market. Having in mind the market timing goal, it is a logical consequence that managerial overconfidence leads to higher and more frequent stock repurchases. So far for the effects of managerial overconfidence on the corporate investment decisions, on the capital structure policy, on the dividend policy, and on stock repurchases. As these audio slides showed, managerial overconfidence has an impact on all these fields of corporate finance. And all the effects illustrated may destroy shareholder value. Therefore, managers should try to avoid excessive overconfidence. I hope that these audio slides could give you a good overview about the most important effects of managerial overconfidence on corporate finance decisions. Thank you for watching these audio slides.